Congratulations, class of 2023. On behalf of the graduating class, I would like to thank everyone who has gone above and beyond to support us and make this day possible. I think we can all agree that without their guidance and encouragement, we would not be where we are today. Thank you to my family and teachers for getting me through thick and thin and helping me reach this point. Thank you to my friends for making my time at Metro one of a kind. Thank you to our Metro community for an eventful high school experience and for allowing me to make some of my happiest memories. Speaking of memories, two distinctive moments have come to mind. The first, which I think many of us have tried, trying to sneak into the elevator with my friends to get to the top floor, because like the bathrooms, the elevators are also very secure. Shout out to the adults who would open the elevators for us. More often times than not, an angry teacher would find us and kick us out. Not sure why. Another special memory was collaborating with my peers to create the haunted house experience and enjoying moving around the field around Halloween. Personally, I was pretty impressed with how detailed their theme turned out, and though I don't think many of us actually watched the movie, we were able to bond and foster strong friendships. It was during valuable moments like these that I realized I made one of the best decisions I could have ever made. During my freshman year, another school would show up being, I made the decision to transfer to Metro. Because of that, I got to know so many new people who are now some of my closest friends, and I was able to take advantage of countless opportunities that would not have been possible had I not been to Metro. This decision, though, ended up well for me, was not easy to me. For a brief moment, something halted me, and something led me to rethink my plan, and that was fear. I feared change and entering a new environment. I feared that no one would like me, and I would remain friendless for the rest of my life. I feared that I would have the same unpleasant experience I was having at the time. Despite all this, I still ended up transferring. Throughout my time at Metro, I've grown to become fearless. I had nothing to fear at all. The great musician Taylor Swift once said, being fearless doesn't mean you have no fears. It means you're strong enough to face them. Instead of avoiding anything that challenges the status quo, I learned to view the unknown as adventure and culture with an open mind. When I found out how to give a speech at graduation, I felt my stomach sink. But here I am. Fear can be a paralyzing force that holds us back, but it can also be a catalyst for growth. It is in facing our fears head on that we discover our true strength and potential. I encourage all of us to step outside our comfort zone and expose ourselves to new perspectives and experiences. Even when things don't go the way we expected, it is never too late to redirect towards better outcomes. By expanding our horizons, we become more resilient and ready to confront the ever-evolving world around us. With that being said, we need not fear what lies ahead, whether that's higher education, the military, or the workforce. An adventure awaits us. I know that we will all go on to do great things in terms of building young adults. I wish you guys all the best of luck. Thank you.
Isn't just any student. He is that student. Marvin is a dedicated member of the QMHS family. He was awarded varsity volleyball player for 3 years and our co-captain for the past 2 years. Recently, he was awarded the PSAL Exceptional Senior All-Star Player. Marvin was an integral part of our robotics team. Our robotics team was the New York City champion for First Tech Challenge, as well as quarterfinalist at the World Championship First Tech Challenge. He was also awarded the New York City Council Citation for Metro Robotics. He is also a member of our ASL club, GSA Club, OWN Club, as well as Council for Unity. Outside of QMHS, he has been involved in NYU summer program for automation, robotics, coding, NYU STEP, NYU machine learning, and Columbia S-Prep program. Academically, Martin challenged himself to take 7 AP classes and 2 college now. Ms. Morosa is guidance counselor. Loyal member, Martin is the only student who will come see her every September to ask her to take lunch out of the schedule so we can take more classes. This would explain why he was awarded College Board National Hispanic Recognition as well as College Board AP Scholar with honor. With an overall GPA of 100.12, Martin will be attending Columbia University.
I'm sure everyone knows that doors are meant to open and close, but I don't think everyone understands that the aspect of living. When an opportunity arises, there are those who seize the opportunity and those who do not. If a door is closed, it doesn't mean that the opportunity will not present itself in the near future, but it instead signifies that you are not ready for the challenge ahead. Our collective experiences have ingrained us with the idea that what we manage to do or accomplish will define who we become as individuals. For some time now, my identity and self-worth was solely based upon tangible things. Extracurricular activities and events and honors that couldn't be listed on my college application felt completely worthless. Their social and emotional benefits didn't provide me with the satisfaction or reward that I craved from any acceptance that. But given this mindset, I prioritized academic validation over my social experiences with the people that I loved and admired. By the time I realized how irrational this mentality was, it was nearly too late. Valuable time was slipping away, and the last thing that I needed was to leave the chapter of my life with any regrets. As I was a rising senior, I began spending more and more time with the people that I admired and cherished over the summer and throughout the school year. Open to friendship, I was able to meet a plethora of underclassmen who each held their own stories to tell. Although I have distanced myself away from underclassmen for some time, I do have to say that opening up to them has been by far the most rewarding decision that I've made throughout my time in high school. This and applying for the decision to my dream university. Our time together is slowly coming to a close, but I know for certain that the knowledge and wisdom that we've gained over the past 4 years will carry with us into the next chapter of our lives. If you were to take away one message from this speech, I would like it to be this. Your journey through life is one of a kind and valuable, and it's shaped by your experiences and perspectives. You must not be afraid to be yourself and embrace your individuality. Embrace the things that make you unique, even if they don't conform to society's standards. Remember that above all else, you are loved and appreciated for who you are, and that your presence in this world has a fundamental purpose. Keep striving to be the best version of yourself, but never forget, you are enough just as you are. Thank you for everything.
Some will say money. officer. He was a police officer that worked in Corona. Invited me to play basketball with his coworkers. Took a liking to me and mentored me. He inspired me to take the test. And because of that gentleman, I became a police officer, a sergeant, a lieutenant. You heard the word persevere a lot today. And that's what you guys have done these last 4 years. Flew by. The next 4 years are going to fly by. And the 4 years after that are going to fly by. And you're going to be an adult, though, right? But love will carry you through. Continue to love one another. Continue to love everyone that's here watching you. At the age of 17, 18, when I sat in your chair, and I looked behind me to look for my dad, he wasn't there. He wasn't there. But guess what? He overcame his addiction. He is now an amazing father, an amazing grandfather. I'm not supposed to be here speaking to a graduating class. If you look at statistics, right? I'm supposed to be in prison or somewhere else, because of where I grew up, all the gangs in my neighborhood, it was a very violent time, a lot of distractions, but I persevered, and I'm not saying that to boast, I'm saying that to inspire you guys, to let you know that no matter what is thrown your way, you can overcome it. There's no giving up, never bend, never fold, never break. You can't make it. Whatever your dream is chasing, you have these people here counting on you, supporting you, loving you. I don't know, I'm big into love. I love love. I gotta say, I love love. I love how it makes me feel and how it makes others feel. And that is why I started that program, because I felt that more youth need mentors. And if you think we all have it figured out, we don't. We still make mistakes. But you continue to overcome, you continue to be a good person, and things will fall into place. Trust me, they will. Your friends, pick them wisely, because you're going to make choices in the next couple of years that will affect the rest of your life. And I don't say that to scare you, I'm just reiterating what your parents tell you, what your loved ones tell you, all right? I think I have about a minute left to make, right? So, I didn't prepare a speech. I think speaking from my heart, I can never go wrong. I didn't prepare a closing, but I'm going to end it with this. I lost my mother at the age of 28. I was 28, she was 56. And that was the hardest pill I ever had to swallow. The hardest pill I ever had to swallow. For those of you in this room that still have your loved ones present, love them, love them, love them. I know you get into fights and you bicker and you might not see eye to eye, but trust me, having them here is way better than not having them. Speaking of amen, my faith carried me through everything. Faith has been everything, and the first time I said a prayer was when my mother almost lost her life for the first time, and the doctors told us your mother's going to pass away tonight, and I had to call my family and tell them, you know, mommy, she's not going to make it. The doctor came back out 3 hours later, said it's not looking good, call a priest, bring the priest to the ER room. Read her last rites. 3 more hours passed by. We were there almost all day, and I went home, for a few hours to get some rest, because the doctor said come back in the morning.
Okay. Keeping this moving. Melinda Cass became the district attorney for Queens County in January 2020, making history as the first woman to hold the office. Under her leadership, the district attorney's office ensures that all defendants are treated fairly and in a non-discriminatory manner while protecting the communities it serves in the most diverse county in America. District Attorney Cass established the co-location unit to solve the world's oldest and most challenging homicide cases and created a 24/7 domestic violence helpline to assist those in need to connect with safety planning measures and other resources. On her first day in office, District Attorney Cass created a conviction integrity unit with the mandate to reinvestigate and resolve credible claims of actual innocence or wrongful convictions. District Attorney Cass' long record of public service began in 1994. She's not that old. But you look good. Yes, 1994. She was born and raised in Queens and educated in public schools. District Attorney Cass graduated with honors from the University of Massachusetts and received a Juris Doctorate from St. John's University School of Law. Please welcome District Attorney Melinda Cass.
If I listen to everyone that told me I would feel someplace along the way, I would never be standing in front of you. I would never be an elected official. I would never be an attorney. I did become an attorney in 1990 as a result of public school education, getting into where I needed to be. So, believe in yourselves. And people say that to you all the time. I know that. And it's hard to do sometimes when you're a teenager, and all the parents understand that, the guardians understand that. But believe in yourself, and know you can be anything you want to be. And as someone who has committed her life to public service, I can only end with this before I give out my award. There's going to be a few people along the way. I know your family is going to care for you. I know whoever's raising you is going to care for you. And they're going to be there no matter what, right, parents? We know that's going to be true. But along the way, I promise you this. There's going to be individuals who you wouldn't even think about. Individuals that never occurred to you when you were at your lowest point or when you need the most, who are going to reach down, and they're going to lift you up. And you're going to be surprised. I want you to remember me saying this right here on this day. You are going to be surprised that it's that person lifting you up and giving you what you need at that moment. And before I give my award, I want to end with this. My values and my look at what success really is when your guys reaching down, individuals reaching down and lifting someone else up to help them for the next generation. Congratulations.
Let's see. said, Raz, are you ready? I think you can do better. Parents, family, one day.
Logan Armani Cordero. Christian Cordova. Thomas D'Elia. Dante Gagné. Emmanuel Kukuka. Jalen Dane. Ethan Murillo. Peter Mitchell. Leonardo Calaboy. Anna Thompson. Miguel Lacoba. Lucas Torres. Jewel Torres. Victoria Torres.
Welcome to the
It's a reality we know this is about them. But you, class of 2023, you prove to be amazing and extraordinary. Through isolation and uncertainty, you demonstrated remarkable resilience as a worthy of hearing of all the resilience. Indeed, many of you also learned that there is strength in asking for help in that point out of our own. Together we learned to strive, to pivot, and to preserve, and to persevere and adapt to every change in your end. As Sir Francis Bacon aptly said, in order for the light to shine so brightly, the darkness must be present. You, class of 2023, you shine so brightly, you not only weather this storm, but also turn it into a beautiful moment. The same admiration goes also to my sister principal, Ms. B, Ms. Vigiano, Ms. Juan, Ms. Bell, and Ms. Lorena. Our dedicated staff, teachers, and faculty all kept all of us afloat during these times. Through this, we all became more united, more unified. I'm going to tell you that during this past 4 years, I actually learned how to say I love you to everyone I met. I never, and it came from a good place because you have taught us so much. We learned so much from you. And you, class of 2023, you went through a lot, but you're here and you made it. The outside world was full of worry and concern. We were all united together as a family, as a Queens Metropolitan. The challenges didn't stop at the pandemic, as the pandemic came on. Just last week, we were sober. Just last week, wildfires threatened to steal precious moments and memories from your senior class. However, instead of being swayed by disappointment, you adapted, found solutions, and ensured your memories were made. You have given me and everyone at Queens Metro the gift of hopefulness, reinforcing our belief that our future are in capable hands, your hands. You are our future. Together, together we have relearned that every dark cloud has a silver lining, and after the darkest, stormiest night comes a bright, beautiful, full day full of hope and ripe with potential of humanity. I have seen you all grow and achieve and accomplish. I can rattle off many firsts that this class did. Each one of you individually and as a group. You have done this proud, applying yourself and doing great and worthy things in so many different endeavors. Let us reflect on some of these. Our wrestling team seized the moment and became the champion for New York City. Our robotics team, our baseball team, and girls' basketball teams reached the finals for their division. And in the academics for the set, we proudly celebrate our first group of Queens Metropolitan High School with Theater Science and Engineering and Technology graduation CO recipients, which recognizes students who opt in to completing specific courses and elective courses focused on computer science, robotics, mathematics, and science. And who would forget, there's our successful participation in the International Robotics Competition in Houston, Texas. They went to Houston this year. And they want to represent New York State, not just our school, but New York State. Also,
class was the recipient, many of you were the recipient and were visited. The recipient to receive citations, and you were visited by Senator Adamo and Councilmember Ian Choman. In addition, this class has received so-called in scholarship on their donation, over $17 million.
Today, we come together to
work with many. To obey my